Want to talk about our opponent? They're bigger, faster, stronger, more experienced. And on paper, they're just better. And they know it, too. But I want to tell you something that they don't. They don't know your heart.
Welcome back, everybody, here to your broadcast of the International 3. I'm Tobi One.
And I'm Waga, and we're here for LGD Orange.
That's right. Malaysia versus the team that has no home. Well,
they have a home, Tobi.
That's true. They have a home in China, but they're a team from all around the world. We take a spice from here, a spice from there.
Yes.
And then just add in some salt, and all of a sudden, hey presto, you got yourself a broth.
They have some Danish glue in there.
That's true. You can't have a team without some Danish glue.
Yeah, we all know what the
Danish
about that.
Yeah, if you don't know about the Danish glue is, well, we could kind of explain that for you.
That's Sindarin.
Yeah,
and all Danish players ever.
Sindarin and Melk. Sindarin and Melk. Like Melk kept EG together for such a long time, and then Sindarin keeps Mousesports together, even though the group stages may not show that of what's going on. While they're currently 1-7 in their group stages, but these are our two teams we have facing up against each other right now. So Neolution Orange, of course, one of the most famous players they actually have in their lineup is actually Mushi.
Yeah, he is a ridiculously good player.
Mm-hmm.
Like, out of his mind on either carry or solo mid. He is like really, really high tier player on any of those positions.
Yeah. The one I love watching though is Ohio.
Yeah.
He was really like, what was his team he came into when he was, it was MUFC, I think it was. Yeah, it was MUFC when Ohio played.
That should be right.
And it was actually the Asia was the first time I got to notice him. And his play was just like, it blows your mind. It really just blew your mind how great he was.
Yeah. I mean, the entire of Orange is the team where you can look for big plays all the time. They don't always have the better, like, entire, how to say it, overall idea or overall strat, like DK maybe, one of the teams that really relies on this, and we saw it in the game we just cast as well, how they can really bring something, turn it around from something that looks so horrible. But for Orange, you more look towards the really big plays coming out of their solo players or carry players, and of course their supporters are also amazing.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, LGDint, team that was created after TI2 and went to China, stayed in China, played in China, Orange has a lot of experience from the Asian scene, and all of them are amazing players as well.
Yeah, no, they are, man, but let's see if they can get their coordination correct today. Because right now, as far as their group stage run goes, it hasn't been the smoothest thing in the world. They ended up having the same results as Na'Vi at the end of the day with 2-4. And this is their first game here on the second day of the group stages.
It should be a good matchup, though, Orange and LGDint. Like, remaining. Both teams have had similar results in the group stage, no?
Yep. 3-3 up against 2-4.
Yeah, so they... And we see Weaver picked up by Orange and by Mushi. He's probably even going to play it himself as well. And we see this Weaver being drafted so much, and he has insanely high success rate during the group stage. And someone said...
It's amazing, because we don't have these massive, stunning lineups coming out like we normally
it's
do.
It's which really is, low
it's
stun.
Really, it's really made an opening for the Weaver to just open up on whoever he finds.
Many of the drafts we've seen, like people not going for too many stuns, maybe one or two, and sometimes even zero. Looking to you, Goblack. but that's when Weaver and heroes like this just really have an opening to play and make the kills happen. Because they can dive so deep, and if ever something goes wrong, you just click your R button, and then you go in again.
You better not be speaking badly about Goblack, by the way. I'm just saying.
I'm good friends with Goblack, so we're fine.
That's good.
It's very I know you have a lot of love for him.
I will defend the man's honor to the end.
Yes. Don't worry. It's a friendly flame towards him.
Nice. All right. So LGD, we're going to go through the second ban stage right now. So they're going to take out the SK. Was it actually orange yesterday? Because I remember there was one point yesterday when you're like, man, this team's got like Magnus and Nykma and SK. And you're like, was that orange?
No, it was not one team that had all of them, but there was an Enigma and Sanking in the same game for sure, yeah. Mm. And I don't know if it was orange playing. I can't remember.
Oh. Yesterday turned into a bit of a blur. We remember some of the drafts, but not the entire
Well, when you go for like 13 hours of Dota straight and you don't really have any time to stop, then sometimes it blurs you up.
On the wonderful thing there for the people who keep watching, they might be blurring up, but it's okay if we talk absolute jargon. They'll still be like, you know what, Toby? Still don't know what you're talking about.
still don't know. As if they ever knew. But Lifesteer and Chen so far against Visage and Weaver. So very early Chen pickup, but LGD and one of the teams that really, really loves playing around with Chen ever since they were, you know, first making their appearances in the Asian tournaments and starting to play. They had some really great success with Chen. And they always used to like roaming around with a Rubick or SD along with the Chen. So far picking up the Timbersaw. Not too much disables yet. I don't see any disable against the Weaver that is reliable, but
same. It's
you could always head into an early Orchid on Lifesteer. It's doable, but it's not even good enough against BKB. It makes no difference.
It hasn't been done for so long.
Yeah,
and that's if the Weaver goes BKB. I'm really hoping too that someone was watching the Burning game and then switches that from this stupid ass Lincoln Sphere build into the BKB and this early style aggression of a Weaver, because this timing is just too long. And we get our first Queen of Pain game for the international,
for the actual group stages. This is the first time we see it picked up, and it kind of makes me sad if I see Mushi on Weaver now, but I guess I will be. But I mean, Mushi Queen solo mid was the best Queen I've ever seen, and he's played it so damn much throughout the year. So
yeah,
I mean, but I almost wish that he would play it.
It's a rough hero up against Timbersaw, because Timbersaw actually doesn't mind Queen of Pain.
Oh well, when you have a Queen that plays to that potential that Mushi could play it, then he would get all that farm that he needs on mid lane, and then just snowball completely out of control, even more than a Timbersaw would, I believe. But anyway, no matter which hero Mushi is playing, I'm always keeping my eyes closed on him.
Mm. Well, Misery, my eyes are closed on you. What's going to be your secondary here? Like, we've seen them already twice going with that Chen, and Rubick or SD was their couplers, and they got options for both these heroes right now. With Queen of Pain, I would not be surprised if they just go in for the Rubick, because you got Blink possibility for Seals, they got the big burst damage from Co-opter Steel, even got Weavers on Chikuchi. It's a field day for a Rubick.
It's a field day, as you say. All of the spells that he has available right now are amazing spells to steal, so I would definitely say go into the Rubick, have the Rubick Chen together, and then if you want to have your safe lane Lifesteer, if you want to have him off lane. I don't like him off lane, because then you force yourself to go down it, but they go into the Bane instead. It's better disables, and even against a BKB Weaver, they can lock him down a little bit.
But while Mushi hasn't picked up his second hero, and you've still got Rubick on the field, that's a ballsy pickup from Misery.
It is, but Rubick and Visage, maybe not the strongest combination of two yet, so we will see. Still, it's quite good, because stealing any spell from Timbersaw for Rubick, except for a Q, the Q is pretty bad, but stealing the Timber Chain or the ultimate is ridiculously good for Rubick as well. So, 5 seconds remaining. Definitely expecting Orange to pick him up, actually.
Reserve time.
Naga Siren
will be their selection instead.
And that should be our support Naga Siren, unless we see an offlane Weaver, which is of course possible, but...
Support Naga is more logical.
Yeah, at least against Bane and Chen, because there's always the risk if you go offlane Weaver, Bane comes in, nightmares you, and then a Chen creep is there to stun you up afterwards with a Centaur, and Lifesteal hits you, you are dead. So offlaning Weaver against a Bane is never fun.
No. No, it is not. So what we're looking at... Hang on, you're saying it's so aggressive tri-lane? Naga,
no.
Weaver, Visage together?
It doesn't... Well, it's doable. Whenever you have a Visage and a Naga Siren as your supports, you can definitely head into that aggressive lane as Alliance has shown us.
Yeah. And then you can leave Corp on the bottom lane, depending on who's the last one, and put a mid solo in.
Yeah, oranges. Definitely.
Yeah, you see, the Gyro ban out by Misery. He's seeing exactly the same thing right now of Orange. With that Gyro ban out, it's like... Either Weaver is long lane or they're taking up a hard carry. Either way, Gyro could have gone solo bottom. And the puck would be the final one from Mushy. So he takes out a hero, which... That can almost show Timbersaurus going a bit more of a long laner. When you want to take out a puck like that, that's a counter hero to a Quap.
Yeah, it is. It is for sure. So looks more now for Orange. Like, they want to have their queen mid, and they're perfectly fine setting it up against Timbersaw, but they don't want to play it against a puck. Puck, of course, being... It's a really even matchup, but Puck has a lot better odds against the queen than most heroes. So, seems like they are securing the mid lane a little bit and should be an aggressive tri-lane from Orange by the looks of it. This is a DK, so yeah, offlane solo Timbersaw. Not gonna say offlane yet, because that could be an aggressive lane from LGD as well.
With Chen and Bane, though, it doesn't really seem like the perfect aggressive lane, especially up against like a Visage, and you don't know what the secondary supporter is. If that's a Coddle in this mix-up too, you already want to back yourself out.
Could even be a solo Weaver down there, in which case going aggressive against it is pretty hard. He can hide on the tower very nicely, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, going aggressive for LGD doesn't look too good, but this team always looks to do a lot of rotation. And if they do a smoke gang towards mid, then even Queen has a hard time surviving against Nightmare into one Chen creep of any sort. If you have the Troll or the Centaur, it doesn't really matter too much. You can always disable her and just go with a DK stunt fall.
Well, she's got his choice right now. Mid solo could be the last one, but we really don't know. We'll have to wait and see how they really want to play this one out. Same with LGD International. So watching where they rotate in their lanes directly after this can be something you have to do. Also, while we've got ourselves a quick moment, make sure you check out all the other live streams. Obviously, we are only one of four of the primary English live streams going out. We are your joinDOTA Studio live stream, and you can also find the D2L live stream, which is with AC and Draskal.
We can multi-twitch everything.
Yeah, yeah. In fact, that's exactly what we recommend you do. Have all four streams running all at the same time. Who cares about the Twitch servers? Let's see if you can break them. we honestly don't care. well, as long as people can still see the game, then if they can't, then we'll start to care a little bit more. But yeah, check out AC and Draskal over on D2L. We should have Luminous as well as LD. I believe they're also there with Purge and Blitz.
Purge is casting today, I think so, with Blitz, yeah, I believe. Yeah.
And I know Cyborg Matt as well as Wagamama are also doing Wagamama.
Yes.
Cyborg Matt as well as Sing Sing were doing a fun live stream as well yesterday. And the other official live stream is Shiva. So she, I believe, just finished casting up the Na'Vi match, so...
Yeah, the MUFC against Na'Vi.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not sure which game she's heading into now. And we have our last pick of this game. So that is a support Naga Siren. There's no other way to run it now.
Yep.
As you have Naga, Queen, Weaver, and Lone Druid.
But a Lone Druid up against Lifesteal.
It's gonna be Mushy on Queen. I am so happy.
You get your wish, Red.
Oh, thank you, Orange. So nice.
It's the little things that satisfy.
This is a big thing, man. This is a big thing. It's not even a little thing. But
so we get KYXY's Bear.
Yep.
We get our Ohio's Weaver.
Yep.
And actually, as far as LGD International goes, so Brax on the Timbersaw, Pycat farming Lifestealer, so Sergei will take the DK. That's a little bit more normal for them. It's still where 1437 and Misery end up, if they end up on bottom lane with Pycat even, and leave Brax on that top lane.
Whenever I look at LGD's lineups, they're always so reliant on their two supporters doing a lot of movement, but that's how this team plays. Like, if you look at it straight off, you know, on paper, you see DK mid against Quap. Okay, Well, he needs to ball run a lot, and he's going to lose mid if he doesn't get help. But with LGDN, they always have the help coming in. They have good rotations, but let's see how it works against Orange, because Orange, of course, are a team that's pretty hard to catch out of position. And look at the starting build of Queen. Interesting build.
What's she going for? Double salve as well as circlet. This kind of feels like a solo lane, man. Let's run through our lines before they hit each other. So Ohio Weaver will have Ned up on the Naga Sire, and Mushi will be taking the role as Queen of Pain. Comes KYXY and the lone Druid is Bearzori scouting out. And coming in behind them is going to be X or Extinct will be the Visage. And that is their full lineup. And, Misery is the first one to tap on the Bear. He'll be the Bane up on this top lane. Brax also hanging around as the Tim the Soul 1437 over onto the micro base Chen, which actually freed up, Misery to do the Bane. Interesting to see. And then Pycat Livestealer, and then Sergei God. He is going bottle build DK for the solo mid, and it looks like it will be Pycat on the long lane to start with.
Yeah. So those are our heroes. And of course, the
interesting to see 1437 though on the Chen. That's a mix up. Like Misery is normally their Chen player, correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah, he is. They switch around a little bit there, which is interesting to note. Normally you have one guy who really plays the Enchantress and Chen all the time, and that has been Misery all the time, so...
Yeah. That's an interesting switch around. Because 1437, like, he's really great at the heroes like Rubick, like SD. The heroes that move around and single target focus supporters. Like that full number five position.
Yeah.
Like Misery's been micro king, basically.
Yeah. For people who are new to Dota, I mean, there are two supporters on both teams almost always, and of course that sounds like the same position, but it's not really the same thing being a 4 or 5 support. You often have one guy buying a little bit more of the wards and playing with less items than the other. Already supporters have a little hard time, but nice DD rune here for KYXY on the bottom. He got so much of the farm on the first wave, got all of the last hits.
And Pycat can't get anything. 0-0. It didn't really help too. The Chen was instantly pushed back to his own base. I don't know if you were watching the Naga Siren. Just hovering around that bottom rune area. And when Chen tried to come into the Radiant Jungle, a Riptide at instantly 1437 just had to back up. He had to run himself away. So he goes into his own jungle. He'll find himself a Sada. And now he'll head back down to the bottom lane and try this again. But already, the advantage has gone the way of Orange.
Surprised you didn't click that courier as you were watching the mid lane there. Thought you would get stuck on it again, that Slalar thing.
You mean Lapras?
Yes.
Lapras? There's so many different things, like the Immortal. Like it's everything that is so cute and nice in this world.
So cute
All put into one courier.
Yes.
I want that courier now.
So far, we see top of the CS chart, of course, being the Lone Druid here on bottom, starting with the DD. He had a really good time. But for the offlane, Weaver is up to 7 last hits now against Timbersaw, so 1 last hit ahead.
God's wasting a lot of time in this courier. I'm just saying right now, that courier's been sitting there for almost like 30 seconds, if not more.
Yeah, he doesn't want to use his bottle before he has to, and he knows now that a haste rune top is going towards the queen, so he's just going to...
Oh, net. He might be in a little trouble here. He's blocked in. Misery in the corner. Center on the other side. She stunned up 1437. There's too many creeps around it. Now extinct. Soul Assumption. 1437. He goes down first. Again, Visage being the hero that will claim the first blood. And he's looking over towards Misery as well. The set of blasts is actually not helping Orange. They're the ones took damage from that. But with the Grave Chill, Misery turns. You got Brain Step available, but being ripped tied up. There's a lot of life points away from Extinct. And the Sada. It's the Chen.
It has more nukes as well. If they can get one more right click with the Bane, it would be easy to get
lasted. He's got Nightmare. He's got to get himself in range for Nightmare. And that is the more difficult thing.
It's not very long range, but yeah. Really nice pick off there. After his death, even, Chen still contributing.
You start to wonder when you see like that Sada moving around. It's like, wait, is that who the hell is that owned by?
Yeah,
you gotta look for the red bars above their heads.
Exactly, you realize it's an evil Sada.
It's controlled by someone else's master. KYXY is not gonna enjoy this at all. Like that Sada still got another 2 hits out of it, and that's really frustrating. Someone like Lauren Drew has only got 600 life points as it is now, 400 life points because of the 2 blasts.
Yeah. I'm impressed by G how well he's doing so far in the mid lane. He's up to 12-0 against 14-9. I mean, he's only 2 last hits behind. Sure, he's a lot of denies behind, but it's hard to deny a queen when you're playing a DK. So far, he's having a really, really nice game.
He's got to keep it up against Mushi. And Mushy doesn't want to give him that kind of space, but you get more space. Tornado now overpowers middle lane.
Yeah, and meanwhile, 1437 also controlling top rune, so really helping out that mid, sending Tornado and holding a rune.
That rotation you're talking about, man, even if he's not directly there.
Even if you're not ganking, it's still contributing towards the lane, but rune is bottom, and that was held by net.
That's an invis too. Misery will come down to look for it. He's already pinging out saying that something is wrong.
Yeah,
question is, sentry ward, I'm not seeing one on either of these players.
Nope.
Which means if they want to, with ensnare as well as Riptide, Misery's out too far. Net could body block him up, but there's no movement coming from Extinct.
No, they don't want to go right now. Just the fact that he's there and invis means that they could get a chance now, Visage moving in. Bane is the target if they want to go.
They're trying to wait a little bit longer. That bear's almost got its next level up. Misery now being attacked and snared up. Where's that Riptide? Well, it's already been done and Extinct locked in. He's got Solar Soft. That's a lot of damage. Easy to pop up Misery. And now the bear has an entangle possibility, but he's been open wounds up and Pycat leeching a lot of life out of that. So KYXY resummons and pulls it back.
Yeah, this top lane is really even, by the way. The CS is almost identical for the Weaver and the Timbersaw. So, no real big difference here. We haven't been looking at it too much because there's so much action on the bottom.
Just once Weaver gets that level 6, the Timbersaw, getting a kill on the Weaver, it really shouldn't happen. But then again, it's like Trixie not dying to a Batrider, so it shouldn't really happen, should it?
He shouldn't really kill the Weaver, but then again, Weaver is a hero with very low max HP, and the damage of Timbersaw is so fast that it can happen. But he has a bottle as well, and he's bottle one, so Ohio should be perfectly fine.
This bottle one should be really, like, a lot more careful. We've got an Orb of Venom and Entangle possibilities up on that bear. A hero like Misery, just like that. First hit Entangle. The random gods, they start to love KYXY. And just that one Entangle and follow-up damage, Misery's already at half of his normal life points.
Yep.
2 points Brain Step just to heal is not something he wishes to do.
And this is not a very farming Chen. He's level 2, in fact. 6 minutes into the game now. He's checking bottom rune, but this could be Naga Siren finally instead.
He's basically sacrificing himself to get winning lanes. DK trying to catch up to Mushy. He's going to pick up that illusion rune. What's he got coming in? An extra clarity potion. Keep your hands to yourself. And Quap just injured, but not dead.
Yeah, and with a full bottle, she's going to be back to mid and pretty okay. She needs to bottle run as well, though. But Weaver is doing it right now, so. Even with bottle running being slowed down a lot, you should use it as much as you can when you need it, pretty much. Because it's a good way to get that little bit of advantage. And mid, are we going to see a kill?
Oh, maybe Mushy does. Throws the ulti, but the stun from God, 17 life points. And Mushy, Link was already on cooldown after he must have come in.
Surviving with...
Then on bottom lane, open wounds over to Extinct. Ensnare, it keeps Pycat away. Rage or not, actually hasn't used his Rage just yet,
Chen
but Extinct,
danger.
He's got himself that full soul assumption. You're right, Chen is the focus here, and that's why Net's right behind him. No more mana for a Riptide, but two right clicks do the job. Centaur's already used a Stomp 2, and with the Grave Chill on Pycat, he's still the entire fight. Now he finally uses his Rage, but already dead. 4-1, go in favor of Orange.
Wow, Orange really winning, coming out on top of these bottom lane engagements. So hard, really, to contest this lane. Visage on his safe lane with a Naga Siren as well. Both these supporters are so hard to kill, and then you have a Lone Druid as to carry. Man, that's not easy kills anywhere.
Well, this is hard kills everywhere you walk.
Yeah.
But this is what always happens when you have, like, Naga Siren. Like.
Harassment coming out on top lane from Brax, throwing his ulti, and immediately Weaver just decides to time-lapse that. As the damage is so high, just from one hit with the Chakram.
At the same time, though, he doesn't have mana to keep throwing all that out, so time-lapse is only 60 seconds, like, cooldown. That's not that bad. Mushy, gotta be a little bit more careful, though, when the top lane rotates down. He'll see a DD rune on the top. He blinks, and he's... Oh! Try to steal it. He missed the click. He missed the click.
Couldn't.
And now, Timber Chain up. They keep going on Mushy, but Brax, the movement speed, well, it's decent, but it's not gonna be enough to keep up with a blinking Queen of Pain.
Yeah, he actually didn't see the Timbersaw as he blinked in, by the way. So he blinked in completely blind of the what rune it was or who was there. And as he blinks, to his surprise, there is a Timbersaw.
The ultimate freak out moment. If he picked up a DD rune then, it could have been such a huge play for him.
Yeah, that would have been crazy, but he couldn't really.
Look at Naga.
Timbersaw, a very fat hero, by the way. he kind of body blocks a lot when he stands over a rune like that.
Middle lane. Well, she's coming in. They got more support here. Sergey being slowed down. Misery is snared for the moment. Ohio nuked down. DK will get the kill. Visage will get a collateral over the Bane. And now going to pick up a double kill here, Extinct. Can he go for another? There's no mana really for it. And God, well, he gets a stun. Quap throws the ulti out. I was on the best example of positioning for it. And now in comes Timbersaw. It's a triple kill, however, for this Visage. What do you give for some mana? He'll be able to kill up Brax almost instantly right now with a blink to a scream. Brax in the corner, throws the ulti out, cleans the tree line up, which makes it easier for Orange to chase him. He gets another grave chill, slowing him down. That bear, what it would give for an entangle.
Yes, one more blink and scream.
Mushy, blink, scream, he gets it. Him. 1437's already throwing the nuke, so he can't get the follow-up kill.
Another huge fight coming for Orange, and now 9-3. Is the score. The EXP is starting to get out of hands now, really.
That was a double buyback too by LGD International. They bought back both Timbersaw and the Bane during that fight.
Yeah. 6-1 on the Visage. This hero keeps showing impressive scores, but it's really the entire team. And we have James Bond playing Lone Druid.
We have a what?
James Bond Lone Druid.
What?
It's when you have 007. It's a score.
Oh.
Never you hit that, Tobi. James Bond. Now he doesn't want to do anything for the rest of the game.
Don't be involved. Just take towers. Looks like Brax isn't going to let him do that. The bear's already scouting out for the 10-minute route. He's going to find the regeneration. Nice thing to have on a bear. Straight back up to full life, go back in, try and kill off Brax. It was amazing. Like, you were talking about it before, how fast Weaver could just die to burst damage. When you've got both Timbersaw as well as Sergey.
Yeah, he went down immediately, and you should also mention that there is, of course,
top lane.
Brain Zap.
Ensnare, Riptide, Ohio. This time he's got the space to attack, and well, he doesn't have the damage to finish off. Oh, maybe he does. The bug will actually get the pick off. The Soul Assumption really helped out from Mushy. There's another Soul Assumption and the Sting. Misery, he tries to do the Brain Zap to keep himself alive, but it's going to be Ohio getting the double kill. Much needed gold for him as well. That's going to be Treads. And maybe a possibility to survive the initial nuke from LGD.
Yeah. I mean, when they go together in Orange here, they're really so strong. They have the familiars now as well. And they just don't show any sign of stopping when they go together like this.
I don't see a reason for them to stop. You got Naga ulti, you've always got to get our gel free card with that.
Yeah, they will try to maybe get a kill on the bottom now, having Infest on the Timbersaw. They could dive in and try and get him, but... See his KYXY goes too close.
He's been very, very cautious with his bear movement.
Good positioning.
Realizes no one's on the top lane, no one's on the mid lane. There's got to be some kind of help coming his way. And that's why he's back and farming up inside the jungle. But he can also be caught out. There's smoke movement from both God as well as Misery, and now they'll find KOXY inside the ultimate. There's no Fiend's Creep available, but there'll be a Nightmare. That bear can start attacking. In fact, the bear will take the Nightmare off. Now the Dragon Tail stun will happen, and support on the way in. The Weaver Bugs latching on both God as well as Misery, and he still cannot get an Entangle to save his life, and Misery already goes down. Infest damage popping out, but still no kill. Mushy, blink 1 second. He gets himself away. Naga throws the ulti. Says, just slow it down, boys. Extinct's got a Soul Assumption you'd like to throw. He's like, please turn off the ultimate. Yeah, they do. He's lost his Soul Assumption charges. Familiars are injured too.
No slow available for Lifesteer. Only 2 levels into it. It's actually only level 6, so... Doesn't have it maxed out just yet.
They got 1 kill, and they backed out, and they didn't lose Mushy. That's almost a win right there, until this happens. And that's bottom tier 1 tower to be brought down. The bear's here, Naga is here.
To hold it. Queen will TP in very soon, and they will hold this.
Even it's snaring up to kill up the Satyrs.
Yeah, it doesn't even die.
Not yet.
Okay, and snaring to harass the Satyrs.
But a little bit of waste of mana, but they got Arcane Boots on this bottom lane.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
In fact, they've got 5 players now on this bottom lane. Yeah. Welcome to 5v5 fight. Mushy's still got his ultimate. They don't have Naga's ulti, however. But at the same time, DK's Dragon Form is still down for 40 seconds. And the familiars actually get a double stun and don't die. Back past the tier 1 tower.
The bear push, of course, so strong. Taking tier 1 towers is not really hard.
It really isn't. Nuke down the creep wave. They only took 1 scream and a riptide. That was it. And the creep wave was gone too. So to nuke that down, then have your entire creep wave focus on the towers, and snare goes on Brax. It's going to be something they don't want to dive on.
There. They don't have a creep wave right now even, so... You know, with the Misery just split push farming mid, he doesn't have a TP, but he has one coming out to him on the courier.
We gotta get back in time if they're gonna try and fight this, but he wants to have his level 6 more than likely. That's the reason he's there in the mid.
He will get it too.
Yeah, there it is. But they're not ready to fight this bottom lane. There's still too many disables that's gonna stop him from getting a good Fiend's Grip off. And now, yeah, there's the TP back. Orange already did the damage they're looking to do at the tier 2 tower. Back to the farm.
Look at Mushi's positioning. He wants to kill bottom.
He can get it. Grave Chill, Ensnare. He's gonna tether himself away, but Mushi.
It's hard to kill a level 4 Timber Chain. Like, when he has that Timber Chain on level 4, he can.
Easier to kill Weaver, though. Fiend's Grip holds him there. TP support was on the way in. And, well, the first one got cancelled. That was Naga, who was trying to come in. Mushi, he's already here with that. Actually, sorry, Naga did actually TP in.
Yeah.
My eyes. My eyes!
Nice cancel by Bane juking the damage from both the Naga nuke and the Queen, but doesn't really matter. As he was on the tower with so little HP, he still dies.
Support's now rotating mid. Tier 1 tower, it's just one tower after the other now for Orange.
Yeah, it's just starting to fall apart for LGD more and more.
Well, they're behind in Golden Experience, but at least managed to level it up a little bit more. Their only issue is that they can't contest. When Orange group up like this, they just cannot contest. They need to have key items available. Hey, Pycat's got 1500 gold that's going into nothing right now. He would like to have an armlet, but what he'd like isn't really reality. And Timbersaw, just Arcane Boots. When we're 15 minutes in on this guy, okay, that's what makes a little bit more sense. Point Booster as well, now coming up with him. So that's looking a little bit better. But still that Bloodstone, at this rate it's going to take 30 minutes before he'll have it completed.
Yeah, and Queen, she will have an Orchid pretty soon. She has the second Oblivion Staff and a little bit more gold to go as well. So needs about 500 more. And after that, she's going to really stop that Timber Saw so easily. Just silence him every teamfight, or even going on Bane or the Lifestealer. All good targets for silence.
Full mech completed for Extinct.
Yeah, it's the kills. 6 kills, 5 assists.
Bear's on the run. Fiend's Grip to kill off a bear. Commitment. There's some really hatred up against bears. The only thing we're missing is a roar, a DK stun, open wounds, breathe fire. They get 300 gold from it. And force KOXY to resummon, which he now does. But the Dire of an Observer Ward, they're watching him do this top lane, but they don't have enough to kill him and his bear again, especially now that Orange, they're rotating top lane. The smoke will break, and that's because God, he's on the high ground. He saw him coming up through the river connector. And now it's the tier 2 town where LGD have to decide. Do they try and fight this or do they not? They start the tornado, but the familiars see him already. It's almost worth a familiar drop. There it is. They drop, they stop the tornado.
They know that if they kill the bear, then it's not going to have any resummon. So that's one thing. But they can't really kill the bear and win the team fight.
Mm-hmm. Especially now the Fiend's Grip's on cooldown because they use that to kill off the bear.
Yeah.
They gotta back themselves out. The familiar's damage is killing off the status. There goes your regeneration aura and the only nuke you really had. And the tier 2 tower, whilst being fortified up here, losing some familiars, being brainstepped as well as just attacked down. Extinct. He resummons. And now they will take out this tier 2 tower, but it will be denied actually.
Nice deny by G.
They move their entire lineup to also ensure that deny.
Yeah, him and Brax attacking from melee at the same time. G getting it. But still, they lost the top tower, and they already lost 2 tier 1, so Roshan is starting to get more and more available for Orange. Of course, they don't have the fastest Roshan slaying, but with their DPS from Weaver along with Lone Druid, they can definitely kill it.
They'll just have to be as quick as they can.
Entire Orca is done, and maybe LGT want to find a pickoff right now. But that's a bait mint, so if they go for it, it's going to be hard.
Someone is. God's here.
Ping on Roshan by Orange.
In they come. Smoke's gonna be revealed. They find Extinct and instantly. Naga throws the ulti up, gives Weaver some space, and the bear's moving in position. And Sergei God should be their main target here. And they have. There's a Quap ulti and the entangle. Lock him down. So DK's already gone. Brax comes through the tree line. The mech charge gives him some life. 1437. He's taken. All of his life is taken away. They never even use the Orchid. Misery. They get the entangle on the way out. And more kills for Visage. He's 8-1 now. Oh, man. And now for the Tier 2 tower in mid. LG International don't have enough players up, and they don't have any ulties up to really stop this either. This really is just the unstoppable momentum of Orange. That would be my summary of this game. And now, they didn't actually have to TP themselves back out again. I thought they might have tried to go for Roshan.
They want to push out bottom. They don't want to miss this farm that's on lane, this triple push coming in, or triple wave. So, getting that lane farm, getting the jungle, and probably going to push even to a tier 2 maybe before they go for a tower attempt. Or before they go for a Roshan attack. Also a lot of creeps here on the top lane for where Pikehead is farming.
It's decent momentum when you got four range creeps behind it. Is he finally finishing up his... Looks like he is going to finally finish up his armlet. Ohio, though, doesn't want to make this too easy for him. He's already with the medallion attacking on Pikehead, trying to force him out of this lane. And with the help from the bugs, Ohio gets even more money. And you see his build? BKB? Nope. It's just medallion with this Ring of Aquila. Again, we see another early-style game build. I actually really love watching these Southeast Asian teams who keep building into early Weaver items as opposed to this, like, 20-minute Weaver.
He's going for a Lincoln now, though.
I'm happy.
You happy?
Okay, I'm not as happy. It could be a Mana
Bane, style. Against the Bane going into a BKB, you don't really want to do it. Because he can always ult you. Doesn't matter if you have BKB or not. Mm-hmm. Having Lincolns at least against a team like LGDint will force one more spell before they can Fiend Script him or Nightmare
but,
him.
But having that used on him, I think, is okay. When you've got someone like Mushi who's jumping around with Orchid, and then you've got Bear and Tangle possibilities, it's not too bad.
Yeah. Now will be the Roshan attempt. Maybe not, though, because the top is pushing in. But I think Orange will still take Roche.
Chen left a range creep in there just to make sure what... Like, okay, now they're going to have a crack? Okay. So it's Tier 1 and then a Tier 2 tower on the top lane. LGD International will claim. It's a Tier 2 tower and Roshan that Orange will be able to claim.
I like the Vladimir's on the support Naga Siren. Really nice. He's running around with 14 armor. Of course, giving everyone his team armor. Some lifesteal towards the back.
TPs are coming back. Mushi's already returned.
Yeah, they were gone for killing Roshan, but they do not want to give away two towers for it.
So it becomes a tower for tower and Roshan, so favor Orange. And also Naga some free farm in the middle lane. And they're looking for... Are they looking to cut off? Familiars plus three heroes are moving up. They're looking for a pick off. And Timbersaw, he might be the one to cut off. Pink's coming towards middle lane, however. Pycap, Rage just wore off, and that's the reason why they want to go in. Ensnare will fly, and Familiars, well, they drop on down. Nice infest, but still, the Dire Creep, it's actually an Irradiant Creep.
He's in the Radiant, so he's perfectly fine jumping just into the enemy creeps.
The only way you got to survive that.
Yeah.
The only way.
Shadowblade on DK now. So he's going to look and get that initiation, and they need to find some kills, like killing off this Queen, or even the Lone Druid. They need to kill off these heroes who haven't died. Not a single death on Mushi or on KYXY.
God?
Oh,
someone has a gem, and Shadowblade does not help you when there's someone with a gem.
Has a Shadowblade for 30 seconds and already dies to a gem.
That's just when you start spitting chips, man.
Not much you can do about it, really.
And... So who's winning on the fantasy points for this? 4.0 for the Visage. So if you had Extinct, or even saying that if you had Net or Extinct, you're looking very, very good for your points.
Yeah, both the supporters of the Radiant team are doing really good. 8-1-6 and 1-1-12 is really nice stats.
Top lane. Battle is on. There's already the Aegis Immortal, which seems to have popped on KYXY. The Bear will get one entangle. He's walking himself a little bit further away. While Ohio, Pycap, he's having the Orchid toggle already. And Ohio, he'll have to time-lapse out the damage in a moment, but not before he picked off Misery. Actually, no, he doesn't. He just pops the wand charges instead and keeps going on Pycap in the corner. And Naga Siren will get the kill with the Riptide. Bane buying back. But they got two heroes on the sidelines. One who's just bought back.
He killed KYXY, but it really doesn't matter when you lose that many. It's a nice kill, but... They fall behind even further.
But they at least won't lose Rex.
Not yet, but that's just because Orange are playing very nice and safe and just asserting more control over the map.
Are they getting more? What do we got? KYXY has a plate mail on the courier. So here's a Soul Curiosity he's building into and a point booster coming out for Extinct.
Yeah, of course. Always going for that Aghanim's.
Trouble mid. Fiend's Grip. Naga throws the ulti. Bought time for a hide of time lapse. And now, Weaver Wave, they want to try and fight this one. Quap ulti is straight onto Sergei. God will go down here. Mushy, he wants to go in deeper. Misery already with the brain set, but there's just too much damage. Mushy with the double kill here. 3 euros now on the sidelines. And GG is the call. 24-minute GG call from LGD International. Orange, taking it home.
The aggressive tri-lane from LGD did just not work that well against the lone druid safe farming with a Naga and Visage supporting him. And yeah, they just couldn't really find any opening for this game. Everyone on Orange seemed to be too hard to kill. You have a Weaver, lone druid, Naga, Queen, and the easiest kill of them all was a Visage, who is really not an easy kill.
No. No. He's tanky as hell, especially with that cloak on him.
Yes. Exactly.
Either way we look at it, man, we are going to go to a very, very short break, and we'll be back here for your viewing pleasure. Game number 2 of Orange going up against LGD International, and it will be followed up by the 2 games, DK versus Na'Vi, which is our game. I almost want to say game of the day, but I'm now almost tossed up between Fnatic's game as well. So
yeah, it's hard to say.
Anything is possible. Stay tuned. Let's find out together.